distinguish between congenital and acquired hypopigmented lesions. And within the lesions, they can be hypopigmented or depigmented. Hypopigmentation in a strict sense means that melanocytes are present, but there is not enough melanin. So there is a difference between the hypopigmented lesion and the pigment of the surrounding. Depigmentation means there is no melanin, but there is also no melanocytes. This is the problem in vitiligo, but there are also congenital disorders featuring depigmented patches, such as piebaldism, which is an autosomal dominant condition with congenital depigmentations, mainly on the ventral side of the body. One marker of the disease is also a white forelock. It means polyosis. Even the eyelashes and the eyebrows may be involved. So it's important to differentiate between hypopigmentation and depigmentation, and it's important to differentiate the time or the age of onset in order to group the lesions and to make the correct diagnosis. The age of onset is a very important issue. Most genetic disorders are congenital or appear early in life, within the first 1 or 3 years of life. And most of them are hypopigmentations and only exceptionally depigmentations. And acquired types of hypopigmentation, patches of hypopigmentation begin considerably later in the in school years, perhaps, or also in preschool age, but acquired lesions appear very much later than these congenital conditions. And most congenital and early apparent conditions are genetically caused or have a genetic background, whereas the acquired lesions often occur after inflammation of the skin. Perhaps dermatitis, all kinds of dermatitis or eczema. There are a number of other inflammatory diseases like lichen sclerosus or pityriasis lichenoides or morphea, which often are accompanied by hypopigmentation. The main genetic disorders of depigmentation, depigmented patches, this is piebaldism and this is Vardenburg syndromes. There are four types of Vardenburg syndromes. All of them have depigmented patches on the skin and have polyosis, but there are other associated findings, such as a broad distance of the inner cante of the eyes, such as congenital deafness, such as heterochromia of the iris, which are associated and differ or are different from piebaldism, which is only a skin disease. There are other features of Waardenburg syndrome, such as aganglionic megacolon, or also musculoskeletal abnormalities, which are different from piebaldism, which is only a skin disease. And the genes involved also differ. There are a number of different genes which can cause the four different types of Waardenburg syndromes, and there is one or only two genes which cause piebaldism. There are more conditions occurring with genetic conditions occurring with hyperpigmentation. The most important is perhaps pigmentary mosaicism of the hypopigmented type. This usually follows the lines of Blaschko, the lines the skin follows these lines in embryology. There may be narrow bands, narrow hypopigmented bands. There may be broad bands. There may also rarely a segmental type of pigmentary mosaicism. And it is important to note that this type of mosaicism is associated with many different extracutaneous abnormalities in about a third of cases. Maybe minor defects, but there may also developmental delay or skeletal abnormalities which can be associated. So if you have a child with hyperpigmented streaks following the lines of Blaschko, a pediatrician should make a thorough examination to look for associated abnormalities. This is not an entity like piebaldism or other disorders. It is very heterogeneous, which can involve many different chromosomes.